Hi, I'm robo-Suzie and today I'll talk to you about how to detect deep vein thrombosis. Also, don't forget to subscribe for more tips in the future. But back to our topic. It is imperative to understand the significance of deep vein thrombosis, better known as deep vein thrombosis. Basically, it is caused when a thrombus, blood clot, is formed in a deep vein. The vein is inflamed, causing a blood clot to form. Most commonly affected is the legs, and it can affect the arms. When the clot becomes dislodged, it can travel to the lungs, and then the condition is known as a pulmonary embolism, and it is a life-threatening situation. If you are a healthcare provider, consider taking a CPR class to increase your knowledge in giving life-saving measures to an adult, child, or infant. Deep vein thrombosis could present with symptoms such as swelling, painful, redness, and warmth to the affected extremity. There are times that a person may not have symptoms, except for a sensation of calf pain that feels like a muscle spasm, but more intense. People that travel for long periods in a car or airplane are at risk, surgical patients, people that have poor circulation in their lower extremities, just to name a few, have a higher risk of developing a deep vein thrombosis. The blood does not circulate well, and therefore, once the person is up and moving around, the clot becomes dislodged and can travel throughout the body. The blood pools becoming stagnate, and that is when the tiny clots can form. If you or family member experience any of the symptoms, it is best to call 911, as this is an emergency situation and the medics have taken a CPR class and are well trained in intervening in this medical emergency. The emergency room physician will order a blood test called a D-dimer and Doppler ultrasound of the lower or upper extremities that will confirm the diagnosis. If the patient is having shortness of breath, the physician will order a VQ scan of the lungs that will help aid in the diagnosis of a pulmonary embolism. And of course, the physician will perform an assessment and ask questions that will help him or her to determine the cause. The CPR class will provide information and hands-on training in performing CPR, and upon completion of the course you will become certified that lasts for 2 years. There are medications and treatments that can be prescribed that will help keep the clot from causing further harm to the patient. Blood thinners may be given, and there are times that a filter will be placed in the inferior large vein to prevent the blood clot from traveling to the lungs. Preventive measures consist of frequent stops if traveling in a car, or if on an airplane, wear TED hose, stockings, on the legs to help increase blood flow. Surgical or medical patients may need to wear intermittent pneumatic compression device that helps increase blood flow in the legs, therefore decreasing the risk of a clot developing in the lower extremities. Consider the CPR class if you are in direct care of patients or if you would like to be able to give life-saving interventions at any time. That's it. Thank you. Please subscribe, comment, and like this video if it was helpful. See you soon.